folks, what's up? So today in this video, we will fetch real-time cryptocurrency prices using an API called FindH in Python. So if you're curious, let's get it started.
Before doing anything, I need you to install two important packages that we're going to use in this video. The first one is Pandas. It's an open source data analysis and manipulation tool. And the second one is OpenPyXL. It's a Python library which will help us read and write Excel files. Otherwise, you're all set up. So I created one data.py file for us. So in this file, we will be writing Python code to get real-time cryptocurrency data from an API and make an Excel file out of it. We will be using FindH API for this purpose. FindH API is providing real-time stock data, forex data, and the cryptocurrency data. And we're interested in the cryptocurrency data. So we will be using the free version of it. And to be able to use it, you need an account, right? So go ahead and sign up here. You need to provide an email and a password to sign up. I already have an account, so I won't be creating one. Let me sign in. Okay, the auto completion, I love it. Okay, let's sign in. So to be able to use FindH API for cryptocurrency data, we need an API key. So in this API section, you have your key. Simply click on it and it's copied to the clipboard. Let's open our py file and store our API key in a variable. There we go. So we have our API key now. Let's look at how we can get the cryptocurrency data. Okay, it's in the FindH.co UK documentation page, and it's in here, cryptocurrency section, aggregates. So with this cryptocurrency aggregates API, we can get the tick bars of the cryptocurrency market. We will make HTTP requests to this URL and we will get a result like this, that looks like this. We have the symbol, total results, and the open, okay, these are the open, high price, low price, close price, volume, and the timestamp. So what I usually do when working with an API like this is copying everything to my work area. Okay, let's see what we can do with this parameters. Okay, so let's create a base URL. And it's simply going to be this one. We need this. Okay, the final version will be like this. Let me show you this one. The final version of the URL will be this one. And we will get these inputs from the user. The symbol, multiply, time, from, and to. So the symbol is symbol of the cryptocurrency, like BTS to USD. So it's basically the corresponding USD price of our cryptocurrency, like Bitcoin, Ethereum, Ethereum, okay? Multiply will be an integer, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the time will be minute, hour, day, week, months. So from is the start date as string data, and to is the end date. So this is the end URL, which those parameters are included. Let's take it and see what we can do with this. Okay, we have this part of it. And we need an API endpoint. Let's remove this one. So this is symbol, multiply, time, start dates, which is from, and the end date, which is to. And finally, we have our API key. So let's ask our users for these parameters first. Okay, I'm deleting this one. We don't need this. So we will get symbol from our users. Let's take it, symbol. And examples might be this. Bitcoin to USD price, Ethereum to USD, or Ethereum to USD, like this. We will also get multiply from the user input. Let's say multiply. And it's an integer, right? 1, 2, 3, like this. So get it from the user and the time input. Time. So what is valid for time? Let's take it. Okay, let's show this to the user so he knows. Everyone knows. Okay, other than that, we will have our date range. Start dates, inputs. It will be something like this. Where is it? Like this. Start dates. It's in this format. So we're telling to the user. And let's make the same for the end date. End date. Make it end date. Maybe a 6. So there we go. We have our parameters and we can create our API endpoint using these parameters. Let's say API endpoint. It will have the base URL. We have the symbol. So let's take the symbol like this. And we have another slash. And we have the multiply. We have another slash. We have time, another slash, and we have from slash. Okay. And finally, the two. So after doing two, we have API key. And insert our API key. So that's it. This is our API endpoint and we're ready to do HTTP request to it. So to do that, we need to import some packages. First of all, let's import requests to make HTTP calls to our URL. And then pandas to do Excel stuff, okay? Let's do it. So I say response requests that get our API endpoint. And I want to show you an example of response JSON format. We made a request to this URL. So with that, we will get corresponding USD price for our Bitcoin. In total, we have 3 results. And in the results array, we have our open, high, low, okay, close price, volume, and the time step. So after getting this type of response, we need the results array. So this is why we need, let's make a for loop for item. So item is each JSON in this response. In response.json, and we need the results. Okay, this is why I'm showing this to you. We need the results array. So in this array, we will loop through this array and we will reformat it. So for all, we will say open. For H, we will say high, like this. Okay, let's do it. Let's create an element JSON file. So we will say open and we will get results from the JSON element. Item.o. You're taking the OHLC like this. Let's copy it so it's going to be a little faster. How many we have? It's like 6. So 4, 5, and 6. open, high, low, close, volume, and finally for the timestamp we have dates. Item.o, h, l, c, v, and so for this we will convert this to datetime. So we will use pandas to datetime for this purpose. Item t, and for units we have ms, milliseconds. So after reformatting this JSON to its new version, let's create here a list, an empty array, and we will push this element to this list. So list.append element. So we reformatted our JSON. Now we can make an Excel file. So let's do it. Data frame variable equals to, we will use pandas, date frame, we have our list, and we will convert this to Excel. Here for the first parameter, we have to give this Excel file a name, right? Let's use our symbol and XLSX extension. And we will say index false, so our Excel file won't have row names. So I had to fix a couple of problems. First of all, this is not going to be from and to, this is going to be start date and the end date. And this is not going to be API endpoint, but the API key, okay? So before making an Excel file, let's find the minimum and the maximum prices, min and the max prices in the given date range. Let's find them. So to do that, let's create new lists for the high. We will store the highest price in this list and low. And we will store the lowest prices in this list also. So let's take them, put them here, and append on them item, say high, and the second one low. So we will store the highest prices, high prices in the high array, and we will store the low prices in this low array. And we will pick the highest price in this high array, and we will pick the lowest price in this low array. So to do that, we will use the built-in min and max functions. Okay, let's say min value will be minimum of the low list. And we will have the max value, max built-in function, and use the high list. So now we have the minimum and the maximum prices in the given date range. Let's put them to our Excel file also. So we will say list append. Okay, what do we say? Minimum of, let's say 7 days, min value, and max of 7 days, it will be the max value. Okay, so press Ctrl Shift P to open a new integrated terminal and give it a try. Python 3 data py. So for the symbol, we will say BTC USD 1 day 2020, and let's say 01, and 1 week later. So it's 7. There we go. It's creating an Excel file. Here we have it. It's not going to be displayed here. So open the containing folder and let's see. So select all, make it a little bit larger. Okay, we have the open prices, high prices, low, close, volume, and the date. So to see the date, let's make it a little bit larger. So now we have the date, okay? We can format this as date. It's somewhere here. This looks a little bit nicer. And we have the minimum of 7 days and the maximum of 7 days. So these are the 7 days and the values. Let's look at the high values. Okay, maximum of 7 days. This one, 98, 85. Let's find it. It's here, right? So the result is correct. And for the minimum, we have 975. And let's look at the low array and find this one. Okay, it's the lowest price. So the results are correct. So guys, that's it. You can take this as a simple example of what you can do with a cryptocurrency API. I will provide the source code in the description below. So if you like the content, please give this video a like and consider subscribing to the channel. Otherwise, see you.